As Talia Dockery's flight to Las Vegas passed over Central California on September 5, the passengers caught an ominous view out their windows. A huge, gray cloud mushroomed thousands of feet into the sky. It looked like the product of an atomic explosion or volcanic eruption. But what they'd spotted was a pyrocumulonimbus cloud, an enormous plume of hot, smoky air that had risen from a wildfire, then turned into a thundercloud in Earth's atmosphere. I just so happened to look out my window in shock, Dockery, who took the photo above, told Insider. I had no idea that it was from a fire until I came home and my son and I researched it. The particular pyrocumulonimbus cloud she saw came from the Creek Fire, which has burned 212,000 acres in Fresno and Madera counties since it started on September 4. That cloud rose to a dizzying 55,000 feet, which might make it the highest pyrocumulonimbus cloud ever recorded in the U.S. It's about a solid 10,000 feet higher than we're typically seeing with the highest of these plumes, Neil LaRoe, a professor of atmospheric sciences at the University of Nevada at Reno, told the Washington Post. Once rare, pyrocumulonimbus clouds are becoming more common in regions like California and Australia as climate change causes larger, hotter, more frequent wildfires. These clouds, which NASA has dubbed the fire-breathing dragon of clouds, can grow so intense that they make their own weather. Sometimes, that weather can contribute to still more fires in a dangerous feedback loop. Pyrocumulonimbus clouds are a subset of pyrocumulus, or fire cloud. They form when big fires cause an upward movement of hot air containing ash and smoke, which can interact with water vapor in the atmosphere above. Ordinary pyrocumulus clouds aren't especially dangerous and don't affect fires at ground level. But when blazes get big enough, and if there's enough moisture in the air, condensation keeps the air inside the cloud warmer than the air outside of it. That then allows the pyrocumulus cloud to rise higher and higher. Once it reaches altitudes where the temperature is below freezing, raindrops and lightning can begin to form, causing the cloud to become a pyrocumulonimbus. Shallow pyrocumulus clouds form over California on September 9, 2020. NASA NOAA in some cases, smoky rain produced by a pyrocumulonimbus cloud can help extinguish a fire, but unfortunately for Californians, these clouds don't normally produce much rain in the state. In dry environments, any rain produced by the clouds evaporates before it reaches the ground. The cloud's lightning can hit the ground, however, and when it does, it can ignite additional wildfires or feed existing ones. Intense winds within a pyrocumulonimbus cloud can also scatter embers, which can ignite fires in new areas or strengthen blazes that are already burning.